What should you do if you have an MTHFR defect? The answer is not automatically take a supplement. MTHFR is an enzyme, methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase. And this enzyme is incredibly important in the methylation cycle. A lot of people have genetic defects that impact that MTHFR enzyme. And I've heard way too many people say that if you have this genetic defect, then you need methylcobalamin and methyl tetrahydrofolate as supplements. But that's not necessarily true. Having this genetic defect shows a potential vulnerability in your system, but it doesn't automatically mean that there's something wrong. A defective enzyme might not work as well as it otherwise could, but that doesn't mean that it's problematic. And there's a way to test this. We're talking about something called the methylation cycle here, which is incredibly complex, but there's one little aspect of that cycle that we need to spell out here. If there's an issue with MTHFR, then homocysteine is not able to convert into methionine and complete that cycle. And so if this enzyme really isn't working properly, then we're going to see homocysteine levels start to come up. And that's exactly what you need to be monitoring for. There are also symptoms that can come along with an MTHFR defect, and that includes a lot of vague symptoms like fatigue, mood changes, various digestive issues, a lot of stuff. So you always want to make sure that you're monitoring symptoms, but really what you need to make sure that that system is working properly is measure your homocysteine levels. Because jumping straight to a supplement is not always the answer, and sometimes it can even make things worse. And if you have or you suspect that you have an MTHFR defect, I really encourage you to work with your healthcare practitioner to find the best path forward for you.